WESH has learned that FBI agents are on the ground in the neighborhood where the 17-year-old was shot and killed.
Several big developments today. Here's what we know right now. The FBI says it's begun a parallel investigation focusing on whether Trayvon's civil rights were violated.
Meantime, State Senator Gary Siplin is asking that members of the grand jury be selected from outside of Samford.
And first on WESH, we've also learned that on the evening of the shooting, State Attorney Norm Wolfinger was at the Samford Police Department, something Trayvon's family says may have changed everything.
WESH 2's Gail Pascoe Brown joining us live right now from Samford with the breaking details. Gail.
That's right. I just got off the phone not too long ago with FBI spokesperson who says that this morning there were members of the evidence response team as well as FBI agents who were here at the retreat at Twin Lakes. Let's go to some of that video. What they've been doing all day is basically canvassing the neighborhood, talking to potential witnesses in this case. Also, they're taking additional photos. They're conducting what is called a parallel investigation, which means it's similar to what's already been done as far as evidence gathering, but specifically, they're looking to see if any of Trayvon Martin's violations as far as civil rights violations were violated, if that was the case at all. It's a comprehensive thing. They're uncovering or looking into every nook and cranny as well as talking to authorities. Meanwhile, the attorney for the family says he has some new information that is of paramount importance. Ben Crump, the attorney for Trayvon Martin's family, sent a letter to the U.S. Justice Department today. He wants the feds to investigate what he calls suspicious circumstances. More specifically, a meeting Crump says took place between Samford Police Chief Bill Lee and State Attorney Norman Wolfinger at the police department within hours of the shooting death of Trayvon Martin on February 26th.
It's one of those things that he's the state attorney, I guess. He could come there, but I understand they also have other people who did this on a regular basis, but for whatever reason, he came that night. And so we're trying to have this whole matter investigated because we just cannot understand how George Zimmerman was not arrested for killing an unarmed teenager.
28-year-old George Zimmerman, a neighborhood watch volunteer seen here in police video, told police he shot the Miami teenager in self-defense. Did such a meeting between the DA and the police chief take place?
I'm not aware of that.
Is it standard operating procedure?
I don't know what the norms are. I think that's important to be investigated. And if, in fact, that is not the norm, I want to know about it. So that's, again, why I, with the Martin family, want an investigation. I want a review, a critique, an analysis, an assessment of how did the Samford Police Department handle it.
Attorney Ben Crump also says in his letter to DOJ, the lead homicide detective in the case recommended the arrest of George Zimmerman on a manslaughter charge, but the prosecutor overruled him.
The family certainly wants to know why the state attorney overruled the lead detective, which essentially let George Zimmerman go free that night.
Now, we also reached out to the Samford Police Department. I wanted to know those same things. Is this standard operating procedure? Did this meeting take place? And, of course, they've been tied up in meetings today, but they did say they would try to get back to me with more information. In the meantime, as you heard the city manager say, you know, he doesn't know, but that is why they're having these investigations by FDLE, by FBI, as well as any federal investigators. They want an open book situation here, and they want to be able to share what information is what. And then, of course, the city manager, Norton Bonaparte, will make any decision that he needs to at this time. That is the latest. I'm Gail Pascoe Brown, live in Samford for WESH 2 News.